All right, good afternoon, class. Welcome back again to ECN 305, Introduction to Econometrics class. Previously, we have talked about the meaning of econometrics, the uses of econometrics. We've talked about the state of econometrics, and we have discussed the ordinary least square regression techniques used in simple regression model. Today, we are going to be deriving normal equations. And the purpose of deriving normal equations is for us to be able to arrive at formula that we are going to be used in estimating the parameters or coefficients in our equations. Now, let's take, for example, given a simple regression model to be beta naught plus beta 1 x plus u, call this equation 1. It is expected that after this model have been estimated, we have y estimate equals to beta naught estimate plus beta 1 estimate x, equation 2. Now, if you take a critical look at these two equations, equation 1, we have the presence of error term, the u, and equation 2, there is no error term. It is because equation 1 has been estimated. And if we remember the purpose of error term in econometrics model, it is to capture other factors that does not appear in the model, but are equally important in influencing the dependent variable. Take, for example, if our Y represents price, or quantity demand of a particular commodity, and X represents price. We all know that it is not only price that influences the quantity of goods and services that will be demanded. There are other factors. So in that case, X is representing price, while U is capturing all other factors that does not appear in this model, but are equally important. Now, the estimated one will only show us the effect of X on Y, and that is why U is no longer there. Then, equation 1 can equally be presented as this, Y cap plus U. So we have that part that is explained by X as Y estimate, and we have other parts that is explained by other variables that do not appear in this model, but have a good impact on Y. So we call this equation 3. Now, the principle of OLS, as it has been discussed in the previous lecture, is to minimize the sum of square residual or the sum of square error term. It then means that everything we are going to be doing, we anchors on the error term. Let's not forget that even the assumptions we made, the classical assumptions of OLS, were made with respect to what? The error term. So everything we are doing under ordinary least square regression techniques anchors on error term. And that is why for us to continue to be able to derive the formulas for estimating beta naught and beta 1, we need to make you the subject of the formula, that is making the error term the subject of the formula. So therefore, we have u equals y minus y cap. Now, let's not forget that we have a definition for y cap already, as it appears in equation 2, which is y cap equals to beta naught plus beta 1 estimate x. So let's put the value of y cap now. So u now equals y minus beta naught plus beta 1 cap x. Then we open the bracket. We have y minus beta naught estimate minus beta 1 estimate multiplied by x. Now we have set a pace to effect the principle of OLS, which is to minimize the sum of square residual. The principle is asking us to do three things. Number one, this residual, that is the error term, which we have made the subject of the formula, needs to be summed. That is number one. Number two, it needs to be what? Squared. And number three, we need to minimize it for us to be able to derive those equations, that is normal equations. So let's take the first one. So we'll sum, we can take the first and second one together, sum and square. Now let's name sum and square equation 4. So we have summation u, that is sum, then squared, equals to summation y minus beta naught estimate minus beta 1 estimate x, then raised to power 2. That is the sum and squared. So let's call this equation 5. Then we can now apply the third part of it, which is to minimize. Minimizing a function is to take the first derivative of that function. That is from the knowledge of our mathematics for economics. So we have to minimize. Now we take the first derivative of equation 5 with respect to number 1, beta naught estimate, because that's what we want to find a formula for, then, and number 2, beta 1, then we equate the result to 0. So that is what is required of us for us to successfully minimize the sum and square residual function. So let's go. We have the summation u squared over the first one. We are differentiating with respect to beta naught, the beta naught estimate equals to, now the approach we are going to be using from the knowledge of mathematics for economics, what we'll do is you differentiate with respect to everything in this at the right hand side first. Then you now differentiate with respect to what is inside the bracket. So we are going to be differentiating the whole of this as one entity. Then we now differentiate with respect to beta naught in this bracket. So now in that case, we have two summation y minus beta naught estimate minus beta 1 estimate multiplied by x raised to power 2 minus 1. And that is taken from the knowledge of mathematics for economics when we have y equals to x raised to power n. The first derivative of that is the y over the x is equal to what? N times x raised to power n minus 1. Now, in this case, our x is representing this summation y minus beta naught estimate minus beta 1 estimate x. Then, our n is 2. So, n times x, that is 2 times summation of all these raised to power 2 minus 1. That is the first aspect of the differentiation. The second aspect is to differentiate what is inside the bracket with respect to beta naught. So in that case, we have, for example, y equals to minus beta naught estimate, taking this out. So the y over the d's equals to the beta naught equals to what? Minus 1. The law says the derivative of a constant is equal to what? 1. Taking the minus that is there, we have multiplied by what? Minus 1. Then finally, you say we equate the answer to 0. So we can continue solving. For that, we have 2 summation y minus beta naught estimate minus beta 1 estimate x. Then 2 minus 1 is 1. Anything raised to power 1 is that same, then minus 1 equals to 0. Now, our role now is to eliminate this minus and the 2 because they are no longer useful in the equation. So, what we'll do is we can take the minus to this side. We have minus 2 summation y beta naught estimate beta 1 estimate x into 1 equals to 0. So, in that case, we can divide both sides by minus 2. We have divided by minus 2, divided by minus 2. This minus 2 cancel this. Then 0 divided by minus 2 equals to 0. So, we have summation y minus beta naught estimate minus beta 1 estimate x. Then 1 equals to, we open this bracket by multiplying 1 by, so we have summation y minus beta naught estimate minus beta 1 estimate x equals to 0. Then we can open this bracket. We have summation times y, summation y minus summation times beta naught. Beta naught is a constant. And anytime you are multiplying a summation with a constant, it attracts what? N. So the summation will change to N. Instead of us to have summation beta naught estimate, you have N beta naught. So summation times beta naught now is N beta naught estimate, then minus beta 1 summation x equals to 0. So anytime you are multiplying a constant and a variable with summation, you separate the constant first. That is why we have beta naught. Then the summation will be attached to the variable. So we can make summation y subject of the formula here. We have summation y equals n beta naught estimate. Then taking this to the other side also plus beta 1 estimate summation x1. So let's tell this equation 6. Then we go from here again. We have just succeeded in the minimizing the sum of square residual with respect to beta naught. So we'll follow the same approach to differentiate with respect to beta 1 also. So we have the summation u squared divided by the beta 1 estimate equals, now the same way we differentiated this, everything here first, then we differentiate with beta 1 in the bracket. So we have 2 summation y minus beta naught estimate minus beta 1 estimate x raised to power 2 minus 1. Then in this case, we have y equals to minus beta 1 x estimate. So the y over the beta 1 equals to minus x. So we have minus x equals to 0. So this 2 minus 1 is 1. 1 raised to power, anything raised to power 1 is the same number. So we have 2 summation y minus beta naught estimate minus beta 1 estimate x into minus x equals to 0. So what we did the other time, transfer the minus to this side to be able to cancel out the minus. So we have minus 2 summation y minus beta naught estimate minus beta 1 estimate x into x equals to 0. Then we divide both sides by minus 2. So this cancel this. And anything divided by 0 is 0. So we have summation y minus beta naught estimate minus beta 1 estimate x multiplied by x equals to 0. So we can use x to multiply through this. So we have summation y times x is what? Yx minus beta naught times x. We have beta naught estimate x, then minus beta 1 estimate, then x squared equals to 0. Then we can open the bracket. we have summation yx minus beta naught estimate summation x minus beta 1 estimate summation x square equal to 0. So in that case, we make summation yx subject of the formula. We have summation yx equals beta naught summation x plus beta 1 summation x squared equation 7. So therefore, equation 6 and equation 7 are now what is called the normal equation. So we have succeeded in deriving the normal equation, which is our equation 6 and equation 7. Now, let's not forget that derivation of normal equation is not the end in itself, but it means to an end. In other words, we have derived the normal equation for us to be able to derive the formula that we'll be using in calculating for beta naught and beta 1. So in that case, let's write out our normal equations. All right. So we have our normal equations to be summation y equals n beta naught estimate plus beta 1 summation x estimate. Then summation yx equals beta naught summation x plus beta 1 estimate summation x squared. Now the next step is for us to apply matrix method, Cramer's rule in matrix, to be able to get the value for beta naught and that of beta 1. Now the general approach for Cramer's rule is Ax equals to h, where our a represents the coefficient attached to each of the variables. The x are the parameters that we want to solve for, then h represents the constant. So in these normal equations now, we have our coefficients to be everything attached to beta naught here, beta naught here, beta 1 here, beta 1 here. The variables here, so now we can extract that out. We have n is attached to beta naught. We have n, then here we have summation x, then we have summation x and summation x squared. So we have our a. Then multiply by the constant or the parameter, which is beta naught estimate and beta 1 estimate, then equals to the constant. The constant are those values standing alone, which are summation y, summation y x. So we have changed the normal equation to matrix form. This is 2x2 matrix, and we can solve it using Cramer's rule. Now, to get the value for beta naught estimate, the matrix rule states that it will be determinant of beta naught estimate divided by the general determinant, which is the determinant of A. Therefore, for us to form a 2x2 matrix for the beta naught, which is the constant, the approach requires us that the column for beta naught should be exchanged for the constant. So when you want to solve for beta naught, you exchange the column with what? The constant. So we have summation yx, then you write this, summation x squared, the determinant of this, all over the determinant of A, which is n summation x, and summation x squared determinant. Then we can solve for this. Now the approach for determinant, let's say we have A, B, C, D. Now we have matrix A to be equal to this. The determinant of A will be equal to A times D minus B times C. So that is the same thing that we are going to be following here. So to get the determinant of beta naught, we have summation y times summation x squared minus summation yx summation x. Now, let's not forget that the arrangement does not matter. C times B is the same thing as what? B times C. So, and that is why this times this, or this times this, or this times this, whichever way, you are still going to arrive at the same answer. Then, here we have N times summation x squared, then minus summation x all squared. So, in that case, for us to be able to get the value of B parameters in any model, we are going to be using this formula. Also, for beta 1 estimate, the determinant of beta 1 estimate divided by the general determinant, which is equal to, this is the column for beta 1. We replace it with the constant. So we have n summation x, summation y, then summation what? Yx determinant over general determinant, which is n summation x, summation x, summation x squared. So then we solve for beta 1 using the matrix method, the determinant approach, this times this. So we have n summation yx minus summation y summation x divided by n summation x squared minus summation x all squared. So this is the formula that we are going to be using in calculating what? The beta 1. Therefore, in any model, take for example, we have y equals beta naught plus beta 1 x plus u. Now, to get beta naught estimate, we have summation y summation x squared minus summation yx summation x divided by summation n summation x squared minus summation x all squared. And to get the value of what? Beta 1 estimate, we have n summation yx minus summation y summation x divided by n summation x squared minus summation x all squared. So if we use this to calculate this, we are going to arrive at y estimate equals to what? Beta naught estimate plus beta 1 estimate x. So this represents a constant. And this represents what? The value of x. So, meaning that if x changes by 1 unit, y will be affected by what? The quantity of our beta cap, beta 1 estimate. So, this is explaining the magnitude as well as the direction to which y, x is affecting y. So, when in subsequent class, if we take numerical example, we'll be able to explain this better. So, in the next class, we are going to derive another formula that can equally be used in getting the value of beta naught and beta 1 using the deviation approach. When you don't want to work with the big capital, you want to work with small and small x and small y. Then we'll arrive at this and take numerical example that will explain how we apply the two formula. Thank you.